We are the wrecking crew of the Testimonial Youth Department.
We are knocking down the walls of injustice and racism.
We are knocking down the walls of disobedience and depression.
Our praise is powerful, just like the Jehoshaphat story. This battle is not ours, but it's the Lord's. Join us as we call for the singers to come first.
It's time to praise him.
Thank you for tuning in. Now let us all have prayer. Thank you, God, for healing the human body. Thank you for giving us legs. Thank you for giving us legs, arms, ears, and a brain to listen and to think. Thank you, God, for not letting us get a sickness or a virus inside of our bodies. You have done everything to help us, Lord. We don't know what's coming, but you, Lord. You're the one that made all of this come true. You laid Jesus out from the coffin. You're the one that put me with a happy family and a happy life. And I just thank you very much for that, Lord. Thank you for giving me the strength to preach and pray today, Lord. And I love you, Lord, with all my heart. And in Jesus' name, amen.
I'm reading from 2 Chronicles, the 20th chapter and the 15th verse. And it says, "And he said, Listen, all Judah and inhabitants of Jerusalem and King Jehoshaphat, thus said the Lord to you, Do not be afraid and do not be dismayed at this great horde, for the battle is not yours, but God's." This is the word of the Lord for the people of the Lord.
I know burden beneath the load of guilt and shame, but then the hand of Jesus touched me, and now I'm no longer the same. Oh, he touched me. Yes, he touched me. And oh, the joy that floods my soul. Something happened, and now I know Jesus touched me and made me whole. Father God, as we come before you today, a God that can do anything but fail. And God, we ask you right now that you will continue to be in our midst this morning. Lord, we ask you that you will move Wilson out the way, and that no fame or no earthly glory will come to me, but all the glory belongs to you. For in the name of Jesus we pray, and God's people say amen. Giving honor to God, to our bishop and first lady, to all of you, to my wife, Dr. Wilson. I will not be before you long today. In Genesis, the 22nd chapter, starting with the first verse, I trust you shall find these words. Genesis, the 22nd chapter, starting with the first verse. And it came to pass after these things that God did tempt Abraham and said unto him, Abraham, and he said, Behold, here am I. He said, Take now thy son, thy only son, Isaac, whom thou lovest, and get thee into the land of Moriah, and offer him there as a burnt sacrifice, burnt offering unto one of the mountain which I will tell thee of. And I want to use just for a moment a subject. I'm all in. All right. I'm all in. I don't confess to be a poker player, because I know really nothing about poker, but the one thing I do know, after seeing it on television and lived long enough, that the game is played where a person has, he thinks he has a good hand. He thinks he has a better hand other than the other players. And he tells them that once he looked at his hand and look at the cards, he tells them that I'm all in. Meaning that he has no cards in his sleeve, no cards underneath the table, no nothing. He's all in. He's put all his chips on the table. He's put all his money on the table. And he indicates to the other players, I'm all in. May I suggest to you today, my brothers and sisters, that in this Christian life, we must be all in. There's no half stepping, no straddling the lines. For Christ I live, and for Christ I die. And here it is, the text this morning. Abram, who in chapter 17 is named the exalted one. Chapter 22, his name is Abraham, meaning father of many nations. 25 years, Abraham and Sarah have trusted God. 25 years since God had told them that they were going to bore a son. And now that Abraham, he's 99 now, and Sarah is 90. And he reveals to them again the plan. And Sarah laughs. Sarah laughs, and God asks the question, why is Sarah laughing? Is there anything too hard for God? And here it is that Sarah and Abraham, Sarah decides she wants to help God. And she says to Abraham, Abraham, go unto my servant Haggai. And if you want to have a son, now is the time to do it. And Abraham, being the man, he went along with his wife's plan. And Ishmael was born. And Ishmael is not the promise that God said. Ishmael is not the promise that he gave to Sarah and Abraham. And here it is that when we help God, you can't help God. God can help you, but you can't help God. And so it is that the plan went awry. And here it is, 99 years. He's 99 years old, and he's about to have a son. And his wife laughed at the situation. And isn't it just like us when we don't believe in things? Isn't it just like us that we don't believe things can come true? But it takes God to make the impossible possible. So here it is that he has this son, Isaac. And Isaac is born, and he's happy. Abraham is happy. He has a son. He adores this boy. And he loves this, and he is the promise that God said. And Ishmael was not the promise, but Isaac is the promise that God said. Isaac is the promise. Isaac is the prophecy son. Isaac is Abraham's old son in his old age. You know the story. He tells Abraham to bring your son, whom you love, whom you adore, and whom you cherish. I need to see if you're all in, Abraham. And let me just flip that coin just for a second. Most of us would have said, God, are you serious? I waited 99 years to have a son, and now you want me to take him up to a mountain and sacrifice him? God, are you serious? Are you serious about this thing? We cannot comprehend God's mind. Folks, we can't comprehend the love of God, because his ways are not our ways. His thoughts are not our thoughts. And my brothers and sisters, here's where the rubber meets the road. Here's where you can be all in, because this request of God is unconscionable. This request of God is impossible. This request of God, I can't fathom. But you've got to take self out of it if you're all in. If you're all in, you can do the impossible. Because it's impossible for a man to stretch forth his rod and the Red Sea divides. It's impossible for a woman to rush herself through the crowd and touch the hem of his garment. It's impossible for the children of Israel to walk around the walls of Jericho and they come down. It's impossible for David to take his slingshot and here we are and kill Goliath. It's impossible in our minds. But with Christ, all things are possible. If you're all in it, walls will come down. If you're all in it, the sea will depart. If you're all in it, God will take care of you. If you're all in it, so the situation will get better if you're all in it. And I don't know who I'm talking to, somebody. You need to know that. Stay in it, my brother and my sister. Be 100%. Young people, I asked my daughter, are they still using, I'm 100, I'm in 100%, or you know, I don't know how that goes, but they say, I'm keeping it 100. Keeping it real. Keeping it, you know, the real. And that's what we need to do as Christians today, to keep it 100. All in doesn't mean that everything is going to be easy. All in doesn't mean that you're going to have a flower bed of ease. All in doesn't mean that everything will go your way. But if you keep it 100, sometimes you will have trials. Sometimes you will have tribulation. If you keep it 100, God will take care of you. If you keep it 100. God, I can't do it by myself. I need, even though I'm all in, sometimes the weight of the world gets on my shoulder. Sometimes I'm all in, but sometimes I can't see my way. But I can trust your heart when I can't see your hand. I'm all in, regardless what people say. Oh, there used to be a song that says, blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. I'm an heir of salvation. And we are an heir. We are all in. And I stopped by to tell somebody today that look at Isaac. Isaac now is a young man. And easily he could have took over his daddy. And he goes to the mountain. They go to the mountain. He says, Dad, I see the wood. I see the fire. But where is the sacrifice? And Abraham said, Son, God will provide. I stop by to tell somebody that God will provide. Look at this situation. Isaac carried the wood that he was supposed to be burnt on. Isaac carried the load of wood of the burdens. It reminds me of somebody else, Isaac. When Jesus carried the wood, when Jesus carried the wooden cross, he carried to a hill called Calvary. And I'm so glad that when they pierced him in his side, he didn't give up. And when they hung him high and stretched him wide, he didn't give up, for he was all in it. And I stopped by to say, if had that been the end of the story, we would be men most miserable. Had that been the end of the story, we wouldn't be here today. But I'm glad that he rose early Sunday morning with all power in his hands. I'm glad that he got up with all power in his hands. Am I right about it? You know what they say, God will make a way out of no way. I stop by to tell somebody, when you can't see God's hand, trust God's heart, because God will make a way out of no way. I'm all in it. Sometimes I'm up, sometimes I'm down, but I'm all in. I ain't got nothing else to give nobody, but my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I'm all in it, y'all. I don't care. I may lose some friends, I may lose some family members, but I'm all in it. I said I'm all in it. I'm all in. Regardless of what the situation is, I'm all in. My granddaughter here, we're gonna sing this song right quick. Come on, come over here. Jesus getting us ready for that great day. Whoa, Jesus getting us ready for that
great day. Oh,
Jesus getting us ready for that great day. Who shall
be able to stand?
Oh, liars will be running on that great day.
Liars will be running on that great day.
Liars
will be running on that great day. To shall be able to stand.
All right, God bless you. God bless you. Let him get you ready for that great day. Amen.
Amen. Amen. I'm all in. I'm all in means there's a yes in my spirit. If you want to be all in on today, and you said to yourself, I'm all in. Whatever God has told me to do, I'm not going to sleep on it. I'm not going to go to norms and eat about it, but I'm going to be all in. If you're going to be all in, bow your heads with me right now. Father God, we thank you. We thank you right now in the name of Jesus. Father God, we are all in. The plan that you have for us is not of evil, but of good. And there's an expected end to it. And we thank you. So today we are all in, Father God. Strengthen us right now, God, for the journey that you have prepared for us, oh God, in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we thank you, God, and we give you glory right now. In Jesus' name, amen. If you don't know Jesus for yourself, and you say, I'm all in this salvation walk, Jesus is knocking on the door of your heart. If you just open up the door and let him in, he'll come, he'll sup with you. So I invite you to come in and allow the Lord to save your life. Will you let him in your heart? Bow your heads. Father God, I thank you right now for your precious blood in the name of Jesus. Father God, your people, Father God, are saying right now that they want to be saved. Father God, come into their heart right now. In the name of Jesus, oh God, be a God to them, God. In the name of Jesus, oh God, your blood was shed, oh God, on Calvary's cross, oh God. You rose from the dead that we may have life and life more abundantly. So we thank you right now, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. And we thank you for the salvation. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Didn't we enjoy Elder Wilson's message today? I'm your youth announcer, Alea Brown, and we are the Wrecking Crew. I'm back, and church will start up again, but we still need to remain social distancing and wearing masks. There will be hand sanitizer stations around the church and outside of the church. And please remember to wash your hands.
My name is Anaya Brown, and in 2010, when the cover-up first came out, I was 5. I introduced myself as Angel Douglas. Now, I hope you enjoy these next 3 scenes, starting with the dream scene. Ladies and gentlemen, the cover-up.
1979, we decided to get married because we couldn't stand the separation I put him through every other week. The more my mother tried to keep us apart, the closer we became. The wedding date was set for October the 27th, 1979. But by the month of September, there was something deadly wrong, and at first I couldn't understand what was going on.
Thank you.
can't get married. I can't get married like this. No! 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 I can't get married like this. I can't get married.
Baby, look, the only other option would have to be to have an abortion. And it has to be totally your decision.
An abortion?
Yeah, an abortion.
I don't know how safe that would be.
Look, you only miss one period, right?
Yeah.
Well, baby, that means that you're only 1 month pregnant.
Curtis, you sound like you've done this before.
Come on, boo. Now, you know I haven't done this before. My older brother told me about this place on San Francisco. They called her medical clinic. Should I ever get into any trouble? That's what he told me.
Okay.
It wasn't me.
No, Curtis. I don't know what to do. You know, I feel like I'm gaining weight. I've been sick. You know, the church people have been talking about me. They've been saying I've been gaining weight.
Baby, look. What I'll do is, I'll call and I'll make the appointment in the morning, okay? And baby, I promise everything's gonna be okay. And your parents, I promise you, baby, they ain't gonna know. I'm not gonna tell them. You won't tell them. Okay, come on. We're gonna do it.